So there's some pretty interesting things that you can do with the Chat GPT. So let's go ahead and test out what you can even do with Chat GPT. There's some really unique things. I was just testing it out, having it create some like web apps. It's very interesting. So let me see if I can come up with something here. Can you create a web app using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript that has a form that takes in a stock ticker symbol for a company, and then on form submission displays the stock market performance of that particular company? Let's see what it comes up with. So yes, it's possible to create a web app. Displays its stock market performance. Here's an example of how the form might work. The web app would need to make use of a third-party API. Let's ask it, can you add in an API that displays the stock market performance data? Let's give it an example. So yeah, it gives you a good example here. So it doesn't recommend a particular API. It's just showing and pulling from whatever an example API. But let's see, what APIs do you recommend to display that data? Yahoo Finance. So let's go ahead and see what it looks like with the Yahoo Finance API. Can you add in the code for the Yahoo Finance API to this web app? Here's an example of how the web app might use Yahoo Finance to display that. It's now, instead of the example one that it was showing, it's now actually adding in the Yahoo Finance API fetch, and then it's calling that ticker symbol. So the HTML here has the ticker symbol there, and let's see if it runs. So let's do, we can do Apple, I guess. So we're getting an error somewhere. Oh, there's an error over here. I'm trying to run the code in CodePen, but I'm getting this error. Now it's wrapping the function inside the await. So let's try and replacing this code, what it just said, and try it again. Still not found. Let's move on to a different topic, but let's say, for just to see what it comes up with, when I run the code, the HTML is displaying not found. Yeah, so it popped out the exact code that's needed, and it gave the div with that ID output that it's being referenced in the JavaScript. Let's go ahead and drop this in. Okay, and now let's test it. So still not getting the right answer to display, but as you can see, I just saved myself like a lot of time just going through this process and working with it. Can you create a Twitter thread on the importance of using social media to grow your business? And it's literally popping out 9 steps here for how to grow your business using social media. You can easily take this and modify it. Let's see, can you write a cold email to the CEO of a SaaS company trying to get a meeting with them to learn more about how I can help them grow their business? So, hi, CEO's name. My name is whatever, Jason. I'm reaching out to you because I'm passionate about helping SaaS companies like yours succeed and grow. As the CEO of blah, 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 whatever my company, I have a wealth of experience and expertise in, in this case, maybe cloud computing or whatever it is for the SaaS. And I've helped numerous businesses increase their revenue and achieve their goals. I'd love to have the opportunity to learn more about your company and how I can potentially help you achieve your growth objectives. Would you be open to a meeting to discuss opportunities and challenges your business is facing? How we might be able to work together to overcome them? This is pretty good, short, straight to the point. Really like the performance there. Let's see. Can you explain quantum mechanics in a few sentences? Branch of physics, it deals with the behavior of matter and energy at the atomic and subatomic level. Particles such as atoms and photons can exhibit both wave-like and particle-like properties, and their behavior can be predicted. Wow, this is, yeah, pretty cool. Can you create a funny story for me? From the software programming side to, even this, you give it a few prompts, requests for information. Once upon a time, far-off kingdom, there was a king who loved to play pranks on his subjects. One day, he decided to play his most elaborate one yet. He summoned all of his courtiers to the throne room. He had a hidden treasure in the castle. Whoever could find it would be rewarded. And that, my friends, is the story of the king and the treasure hunt that was the treasure itself. Pretty good. Let me see what it says. Can you tell me a joke with puns? I'm a huge fan of puns. Let's see what it comes up with. Why did the tomato turn red? Because it saw the salad dressing. Pretty traditional joke there. So again, you can kind of see its capabilities there. Let me see. I'm on a new diet right now, an anti-inflammatory diet. So let me see if I could come up with the recipes for that. Can you create a anti-inflammatory diet recipe for me using chicken as the main protein? So here's a simple anti-inflammatory diet using chicken, lemon, and herb roasted chicken. That's pretty good. I actually have been eating something similar recently. So it's got the list of ingredients there. It's got the instructions that you do. Wow, yeah, you got the combinations. So very impressive. I was testing this out the other day on coming up with text messages. So I wanted to send something to my wife. So can you create a text message for my wife saying how thankful I am for her and how much I love her. Let's see what it comes up with. My dear wife, I wouldn't say that, but obviously it's, it gives you something to work with. I just want to take a moment to tell you how thankful I am, how much I love you. You're my rock, my support, my happiness. So lucky to have you in my life. I don't know what I would do without you. Thank you for being everything I need and more. Love you more than words can say. Yeah, I mean, I like it, but it's like really sappy. Let's see, can you make it less sappy? Yeah, this is a good. I like this. It's adding in humor. Love you more than pizza. That's good. Can you add in some puns to that text message too? So here's a pun. Beautiful wife mine, how much I appreciate everything you do. You're the sauce to my pasta, the icing to my cake, cheese to my pizza. Oh, I don't know what I'd do without you. Thanks for being my partner in crime, my biggest fan. Yeah, that's pretty good. I like that. Pretty interesting. I mean, that's getting more towards something that I would say. So yeah, I like everything that you can get here. That's pretty cool. So let me test one more thing. But as you can kind of see, there's a lot of capabilities here that you can get with the Chat GPT. So let's do another kind of science question. Can you explain why the beach has waves and tides? I've been testing out coming up with like video scripts for different pieces of video that I'm going to be doing. So yeah, there's a lot that can be done. So yeah, it's explaining beach, why there's waves at the beach. So beach has waves and tides. It's the movement of the Earth's oceans being influenced by gravitational forces of the moon and the sun, rotation of the Earth, shape of the ocean floor, where waves are created when the wind blows across the surface, causing the water to move in a circular pattern. So the size and strength of the waves depends on the wind speed and the distance over which the wind blows. I love this. So now with, the holiday season here, let's ask it actually, what are some of the best gift ideas for Christmas to get my dad? Let's see what it comes up with. There's a lot that can be done. Yeah, so here's some great gift ideas for my dad. He's not a golfer, so that one wouldn't work. Yeah, new wallet watch, that's a good one. Gift card is usually a go-to of mine. He likes that because he can go spend it on what he wants. Book is another one. Piece of artwork or decor for the office or home. Yeah, this is great. Yeah, getting a gift certificate for some kind of experience is another common one. This is great. Yeah, I love this. Let me see if it can show like site analytics, site traffic analytics. Can you display the site traffic analytics for convergeblog.com? But as you can see, again, there are still some limitations, but overall, very impressed with what you can do. I mean, we just explored a lot of different things, different capabilities. So highly recommend, yeah, everyone to check out Chat GPT. I'm working on potentially, seeing what the API connections can do because there's a lot of help that this can potentially provide, to chatbots and different things, but also a lot of concerns, the training sets and the data that it's being used to access. That's, who has access to that if it's a centralized entity. I'm a huge fan of decentralization and Web3 technologies being for, decentralization, where each individual has their own power and control over how they live their life, what tech tools they use, who they associate with. So AI kind of centralization and governance, that's another big topic area to think about and explore. But thank you so much for tuning in. I hope that this gave a lot of insights on what Chat GPT can do, and maybe got you some more brainstorming ideas on some capabilities here. But hopefully going to be doing some more content on Chat GPT soon. So definitely like and subscribe if you're not already, and make sure the notification bell is turned on to be notified of some more upcoming content. And with that, I will catch you next time. Remember to keep moving forward. Bye-bye.